has a 60-minute time limit. Your referee in charge, Michael Witchcatcher. Introducing the contenders. First to my right, he hails from Abbotsford, British Columbia, and weighs in at 240 pounds. He's the recent winner of the Royal Rumble match. We have Romero Rumble 2. He is the Mighty Lokombo.
Patrick, referee in charge, showing the belts to both contestants here. And giving it to our very own Mike McGuire, keeping the gold until the champion is crowned.
You better not leave.
Welcome back, Mike. Welcome back. How did it feel to hold the gold in your hand?
It's one of those moments where you feel unworthy, especially when you see these two competitors in the ring. We're going to be vying for this championship again, fans. For those of you just joining us and don't know the news, the match was originally supposed to be Nick Aldis, the national treasure, the cream of the Commonwealth, defending that championship against Harry Bulldog Smith. First, Harry Bulldog Smith. Taken out by injury. We've talked about it. Appendicitis, diverticulitis. They removed a large portion of his colon. And then Nick Aldis getting the opportunity of a lifetime. The new general manager for WWE's Friday Night Smackdown. A role he's taking very seriously already. And unfortunately, that meant having to forfeit and relinquish the Stu Hart Heritage Heavyweight Championship. But now it's about these two competitors in the ring. And we see the Mighty Lokombo taking on Chris Adonis. And already taking the veteran into the corner.
It's unbelievable. I got to ask you, what did it feel like in there when you were announcing these two specimens? Because we could feel it out here. I mean, the tension you could cut with a knife.
Well, the funny thing is, when you got a guy like Chris Adonis, who is out to still prove that he's still got it, prove that he's still worthy of being a champion, and you have a guy like Lokombo, who is still just over a year into his wrestling career, but are doing amazing things, you can tell both these guys are very hungry, but for very different reasons.
Well said. Opportunity of a lifetime, no question.
Well, and this is a title, again, don't forget, that Harry Smith held for almost 3,000 days. Now, I know we want to talk about people in other promotions that have had long title reigns, but this is a title that went around the world. Harry defended it everywhere he could, and now wants it back, but has to wait until he gets cleared back in the ring as Adonis. And a quick hip toss over on Lokombo.
And I love that bravado, putting his hands up, saying, what do you got? What do you got?
Well, don't forget, guys, it happened recently at the Romero Rumble 2, where Lokombo actually eliminated Moose from TNA Wrestling to win that battle royal. And Adonis, quick body slam on Lokombo. And the body slam, a simple move, but you can see the level of force that Adonis put on that body slam.
And now he's just taunting him.
I don't know if he's taunting him so much as saying, hey, kid, just so you know, you're not in here with a rookie.
Exactly. It's the rookie versus the veteran. This is what I'm liking in this.
Who do you got in this one, Mitch?
Well, you know, I'm going to go down the middle, Mike. I don't really take sides / Chris Adonis, obviously. I mean, look at this guy. He's a friend of mine. And let's call it what it is. I mean, any guy that lost to, the national treasure, the way I look at it, it's understandable. It's understandable. So he's got one up on the rook.
Well, Adonis still a great competitor, still someone who's lauded by the fans. Lokombo definitely making an impression, though. And the only impression made there was that shoulder tackle from Chris Adonis. Flexing the pecs. And look at the kind of shape that Adonis is in.
It's unbelievable. And, you know, if we go back, we remember that some would say that Adonis was robbed from the Stu Hart Championship and his go-around. And maybe there's a sense of entitlement coming with him to the match tonight.
Well, that's weird. I don't remember that at all, Dimitri. I thought it was a very clean and fair match.
Selective memory from Mitch Hanzius as we continue watching the Mighty Lokombo now trying to use the tools that he's gained in his short career against this crafty veteran. A series of blows in the corner. And this time Lokombo nailing a series of shots, and Adonis shook up. Manages still to get out of the way of the drop kick, and now Adonis kills a world neck breaker.
Beautifully done.
Of course.
Shoulders down for two as Masters on Lokombo. Now Masters isolating the shoulder and neck area of Lokombo. And when you have shoulders and neck like that, you're going to be chipping away at that for a while.
Well, we know what that's setting up for. But the question is he going to be able to get his arms around it? Because the Mighty Lokombo is massive.
He gets that full Nelson Master Lock in. Chris Adonis could be your new Stu Hart Heritage Champion. But Lokombo doing what he can just to shake off the pain from impact here as these continued blows by Adonis. You know, it's amazing when you see what looks like a very simple rudimentary move, but just remember, these are both guys over 200 pounds that are just landing on each other's body parts. I mean, that's full force impact. And Lokombo getting fired up with a series of right hands, but stopped with a boot to the midsection, and now Adonis with a hard elbow to the face. And this time, it's all Adonis sizing up with a big leg drop. Again, simplicity, but it's getting the job done against Lokombo.
Well, and that's the thing that I see as a true game plan here. He knows where he wants to take it, and he's mounting his offense exactly crafting to that game plan.
Oh, look at this. Oof. Trying to soften up that neck some more now, retching on the head, pulling. If you've ever slept crooked, you know what that feels like. Now imagine having 280 pounds making you sleep even more crooked.
You're just softening it up a little bit later.
I have two young girls. I don't sleep.
That entire series of commentary from both you guys was poorly timed. Poorly timed. Back in the ring. Lokombo trying to fire up some defense here. Getting the energy of the fans behind him. And that's the thing, for a relative unknown, Lokombo has a charisma with these fans we haven't seen in a while from a brand new wrestler. Lokombo now driven into the corner. Oh my goodness! And now Lokombo with a boot to the midsection on Adonis. Now reversal. Shoulders now, but you got to wonder how much impact can he actually have with those, because that's got to be hurting Lokombo as much.
Oh, there we go.
As much as it's hurting Adonis. And Adonis with a series of chops. And right hands. Just a dangerous combination. And again, look at how cut up the masterpiece is. Adonis driving a knee into the spine of Lokombo.
And I love the pace that he's enacting here.
I don't know how these guys are going to settle this one, but we have to have a champion. 60-minute time limit in all Dungeon Wrestling Championship matches, so they've got lots of time to work. But the question is, who's going to outlast the other? And both of these wrestlers, fan favorites. So it's even harder to tell, but as you see, the masterpiece hooking in, pulling back on that face and leg, going for almost a modified Cobra clutch.
There it is.
Sinking it in.
We're going to have to see how mighty this Lokombo is.
Lokombo not too far away from the rope if he knows where he is. he might have a chance to reach out and get it, but...
If he could get on his knees.
Wait a minute. Trying to power out, and Adonis getting the chance to put Lokombo down once again.
You're watching the difference between a veteran and a rook. Like, it is a masterpiece. Look at this. He's just dominating the whole match.
Yeah, but remember, this rook has eliminated veterans in that battle royal, Mitch. This rook is learning faster and faster every time he gets out of the ring. And here in Dungeon Wrestling, he's been preparing for this match.
What's he learning right now, Mike, that his back can be turned into a pretzel of some kind? What exactly is he learning?
Right now, he's learning that if he gives up, he's going to lose the Stu Hart Heritage Heavyweight Championship, and he doesn't want to do that. Shoulders down for two. And Chris Adonis learning that the Mighty Lokombo not willing to give up easily. Adonis with an elbow driving into the shoulders again, and now twisting that neck some more. Again, those shoulders and neck, if he gets that master lock locked in, it's going to be over for the Mighty Lokombo.
The way he's wearing him down, if it even makes it that far. I mean, this is, to Mitch's point, very one-sided so far.
Look at the condition of both these guys, though. Both of them finding out they were going to get this match just a few weeks ago. And both telling me back behind the scenes that they were doing extra cardio, extra weight training, everything they could to get ready for tonight in the short time that they had.
You have no choice. You know what's on the line.
You know, Mike, I mean, seeing these two guys and their bodies, I'm the exact same way. I understand what they're going through right now because I'm pretty close to what this is, and I get it. I mean, their muscles are fatiguing right now. I get it.
Yeah, being a body guy doesn't mean just having a lot of body. Adonis now driving a knee into the side. Wait a minute. Lokombo, shoulder tackle followed by a clothesline and another. And it's all Lokombo firing back against Adonis. Go behind. Drives the knee into the back and then side suplex. And Adonis is down. Is it enough for the newcomer? Rolls him over. Taking too much time.
He's got to stay.
Adonis on the mat. What are you doing, Lokombo?
Wow.
Standing moonsault for two. And Lokombo, an amazing maneuver, maybe just didn't quite get enough.
He's trying to win over the crowd, Mike, and that was his little rookie mistake again. We go back to it.
You'd have to think, though, if he had gotten the full impact with that massive upper body of his onto Adonis, who to the midsection now. And Lokombo picking up Adonis, holding him high. Standing vertical suplex, and Adonis is down. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Almost a new Stu Hart Heritage Heavyweight Champion in the form of the Mighty Lokombo.
That took a lot of energy for Adonis to kick out from that.
Lokombo's asking Fitzgerald what's going on. He says, hey, I've been working every match. I'm exhausted.
Lokombo now firing up. What's he got planned? Off the ropes. Big diving elbow, but Adonis rolls out of the way. Adonis. Spine on the pine. Hooks the leg. Referee down. One, two. Almost three.
Oh, I thought he had him there.
Put yourself in this situation, guys. If you're Chris Adonis, you're a veteran, and you haven't quickly put away this rookie, as you like to call him, Mitch, what's going through your mind?
You know what? Listen, he's working the magic. He's working what he's doing. He's wearing him down. It's a little frustrating, but he's got it.
Adonis calling for it now. If he gets that full Nelson in, it's going to be over for Lokombo. One arm in. Gets the other. Lokombo fighting as hard as he can. Adonis trying to lock those fingers. If he gets it in, it's over.
Great ring awareness by the Mighty Lokombo.
Lokombo managing to drive Adonis into the turnbuckles. Catches him! Running power slam! Almost a was almost champion again.
He held him there and drove the point on that power slam.
Go ahead, keep calling this guy a rookie. That's three times now we've seen this guy almost become the new Stu Hart Heritage Heavyweight Champion.
Almost. I've said it three times. I agree.
Adonis scrambling back to his feet. Lokombo calling for something. Again, we're just getting to know the Mighty Lokombo. Chris
crowd.
Adonis getting to know the Mighty Lokombo real well. Wait a minute now. Picks him up. What is this going to be? Looks like he was setting up for some type of power slam now. Could be getting the master lock in. Could the masterpiece? Reversal. Going for a master lock of his own. What is going on?
That would have been a statement.
Adonis drops down. Rolls over. Sunset flip by the pin.
Gentlemen, what have I been saying? What have I been saying?
Wow. What a match. Just when you think it's going to end. Expecting it to end in the master lock. Everything he was working for the whole match, that's the experience, Mitch. It just gets him in that roll up. And maybe to your point, rookie mistake.
It was exactly that, but that's okay. Listen, Mighty Lokombo won some respect tonight with the fans, and that might have been a deterrent. He wanted the fans to love him more than he wanted the belt tonight, Dimitri.
No question about it. Let's get to ring. They're meeting each other in the middle. Sign of respect. And respect earned.
I'm not going to say it. Not going to say it.
You're not a fan of the handshake.
I'm not a fan of the handshake, but you know what? This is when one time I'll say, you know what, Lokombo? You're learning, and he's on his way. And I mean, this kid, think about it. He's a couple of matches here in Dungeon Wrestling and already fighting for the title. Huge future for this kid. Adonis is going to represent the Heritage belt very well. Well done, well done. What a win. And he shows you he can win any which way.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, and you can see what it means to hold that coveted, that precious belt. You can see what it means. Work so hard and to get. But now comes the second part. He's going to have to defend it. And he's going to have to take on all challengers, however they present themselves. And something tells me that the Mighty Lokombo's not finished yet either, Mitch.
Oh, absolutely not. Look at this guy. He's going to be a great representative of the Heritage belt.